guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Shannon. Thank you so much for stopping by today. In today's video, we are going to be using the Hot Topic Clueless Totally Buggin' Palette. It retails for $16.90. I did get mine on sale for $10. This is what the outer packaging looks like. And this is what it looks like inside. It has a cute little heart mirror, and it says, "Your Total Betty," right on the mirror. This is what the shades look like, and I actually did swatch this in one of my videos, my chatty catch-up check-in video. It says down here, "Some people are not lucky enough to be as naturally adorable as you." I absolutely love the shades in here, and I have really been wanting to get into more Hot Topic makeup, into like reviewing it. So this did swatch amazingly well. The pigments were there. Let's see how it performs on the eyes, though. Hopefully, fingers crossed, it turns out good. I am wearing some BoxyCharm items today. I put on the Touch and Soul No Pore Blem Primer. I think this retails for $26. I could be wrong. And I also have on top of my foundation, I have on the Pretty Vulgar Bronzed B bronzer that I can't open now. It is in the shade 113, Bronze Mannequin. I am actually really excited I got this one instead of the highlighter. This retails for $32. I have enough highlighters and I never have enough bronzer. So congrats to all of our giveaway winners. That was so fun. I'm so happy everybody won. Thank you everybody else who supported me that did not win. Hopefully in the next month or so we'll get another giveaway going. And I did just get off work, so I came home and put on my face makeup. I don't have any other makeup on though, no eye stuff, no lip stuff. I will also be pairing this look with the Blackheart Matte Liquid Lipstick in the shade, I don't know, because they don't have shade names. And this one, you guys, I swear, is a really good dupe for the Jeffree Star Can't Relate Lippy. I did swatch them, and they are so close. How much did I pay for the lippies? I think I paid, $8.90 for 4 lippies, and I did wear the black one. Sorry, that's my husband letting me know he's almost home, so I can, turn the camera off so they don't interrupt us. I did wear the black one in my last video, and I absolutely love the formula. It lasted all night, no transfer, so, well, that's it. Saturday, check out my video. Blendy Baby and I will be putting up our first ever collab using the Morphe James Charles palette. So without further ado, if you would like to see me use this palette to create a fun eyeshadow look, then keep watching. I love how aesthetically awesome this is. So without further ado, let's get right on into the video.
Story of my life. Story of my life. La 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 la. Story of my life.
Come on, take a step towards me, so you can figure me out.
I've been hoping and praying for a single way to show you what I'm all about. And I know,
and I know this is the only way of pleasing the crowds. But when this is over and done with and we walk away, there should be no doubts.
So let's get a little closer now. Let's get a little closer now.
You say
that we're all tied up and wrapped around in useless
state of mind.
But at the same time, we're still young. We had the time to realize that we were wrong. Run with me.
Get the hell out of this town
so we can get a better feel for each other.
I'll take you back to
when you remembered how you used to
live your life a little for me.
Take the time to let it go. Step away and watch me grow.
So now
you say that we're all tied up and wrapped around in useless
states of mind.
But at the same time, we're still young. Had the time to realize that we were wrong.
If you want to,
and I'd write to you and tell you how you've always been so special to me.
If you want to, and I'll try. You can say if you want to,
and I'd write to you and tell you how you've always been so special to me.
If you want to, and I'll try to keep you close to me.
To keep you close to me.
To keep you close to me.
You say
that we're all tied up and wrapped around in useless states of mind.
But at the same time, we're still young. We had the time to realize that we were wrong.
Come on, take a step towards me, so you can figure me out.
I've been hoping and praying for a single way to show you what I'm all about. And I know
this is the only way of pleasing the crowds. But when this is over and done with and we walk away, there should be no doubts.
So let's get a little closer now. Let's get a little closer now.
You say
that we're all tied up and wrapped around in useless
states of mind.
But at the same time, we're still young. We had the time to realize that we were wrong. Come on, love, run with me.
Get the hell out of this town so we can get a better feel for each other. I'll take you back to
when you remembered how you used to
live your life a little for me.
Take the time to let it go. Step away and watch me grow. So let's get a little closer now. Let's get a little closer now.
You say
that we're all tied up and wrapped around in useless
states of mind.
But at the same time, we're still young. Had the time to realize that we were wrong.
If you want to,
and I'd write to you and tell you how you've always been so special to me.
If you want to, and I'll try. You can say if you want to,
and I'd write to you and tell.
Alright guys, so I'm back with the finished look and kind of on the fence about this eyeshadow palette. Where to begin? Well, it's not my favorite look I've ever come up with, but I could still comfortably wear this out in public and be pretty confident about my makeup. I'm like looking at it in the mirror thinking, like, what do I think about this? For $10, it's okay. I don't really like how the formula is. I don't like the eyeshadow formula and how it performs. That's what I was trying to say. Like, with the purple, I really didn't expect this color and this color to wash into each other, but they did. It's like fabulous, this top shade, just washed right into the lighter purple and just made it all look darker, which I guess happens when you use the same shades. Like, if you use a red and a darker red, you're going to have red. If you're going to use a pale pink and a darker pink, you're going to have pink. But I really thought it was going to just darken up the edge. And then let's talk about this shade, Homies. Definitely was hard to build up, but once I used a synthetic brush, when I did this eye off camera, it actually wasn't too bad. I was able to do this one a lot quicker, but I used a synthetic brush. The other eye, I used the goat hair brushes. And then my last complaint, when I used this brush to use the shade Total Betty, oh my god, you guys, I actually hit pan on this right in the corner. If you look in this wee corner, I hit pan. That's what I was going to say. Total Betty is wrecked from one application. And it's really weird because, like, the edges of it are making this really weird, like, little balled up effect. Which I guess happens on high end. Oh, I've had this happen on, like, one or two high end palettes. Where when you use a wet brush, you get the little pebbles of hardened eyeshadow on the top. And it's actually really easy to get rid of. If you've ever had that problem, take a piece of scotch tape, put it all over the top of the eyeshadow, and rub it across, and it'll take those little pebbles right off your eyeshadow and basically, like, give you a fresh layer of eyeshadow. How many times is Shannon gonna do this? I didn't end up wearing the apocalyptic henbane, I always say it wrong, the pigment for my highlighter, and then I put the Laura Geller highlighter over it. Oh my god, my husband's phone is ringing. Alright, sorry, that was the pizza company. They're bringing our pizza delivery and they couldn't find our condo. So anyways, I'm wearing this as my highlighter, and I did end up wearing the Lippy by Blackheart Cosmetics, and now I can't find it. Here it is, this one. And that is it. Oh, I have my purple ColourPop BFF mascara on called Purple Pros. So, all in all, not my favorite palette. I really didn't enjoy the blending and the performance of the eyeshadows, but it doesn't mean I won't give it another chance. Next time, though, this one is not made by Blackheart Cosmetics. The next palette I get from Hot Topic will be a Blackheart Cosmetics palette. I'm going to try to get one of those next. So, it's okay. This is made by Blackheart Cosmetics. I'm still going to do a little video using this guy or pair this with the next palette that I get from them. It's just this one's kind of small to do a whole video on. So, all in all, I enjoy the look. Like I said, I still would wear this out in public, but it's not my favorite eyeshadow formula, but for $10, I'll keep it. I mean, obviously, I'm going to keep it. I'm not going to return a $10 palette, but I'll hang on to it for a little bit, and then I'll probably end up giving it to my mother-in-law, because she loves getting makeup from me. If you guys would be so kind and head over to my Instagram, there's a picture I posted, a throwback picture of me when I was, like, 17 wearing makeup, and I was in downtown Cleveland, and it says beauty is soul deep. If you guys could go to that picture and click on the link and give me a testimonial for joining the Sephora squad. It's just an application to become a product tester for Sephora, kind of like an influencer for Sephora. So pretty please go over there and click that button. If you're new here and you're not already subscribed to my channel, I would be so grateful if you would consider subscribing for me and hit that notification bell. And if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a big old thumbs up. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. And if you will be purchasing any palettes from Hot Topic. Thanks for stopping by, guys.